space, the boundary of human achievement, the new frontier.
It's just a cough.
Yeah, right. And the earth is flat.
Treat your cough seriously with Robitussin CF Max. Nothing lasts longer and treats more symptoms for your cough, cold, and flu. Robitussin, because it's never just a cough.
In a few moments, you will have an experience which will seem completely real. It will be the result of your subconscious fears transformed to your conscious awareness. Warning, this tape must not be played by government personnel. It can be extremely harmful and result in severe trauma. You have 5 seconds to terminate this tape. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Hold him. Now you listen to me, you hillbilly punk who thinks the world's still round. I'm here to tell you it's not. It's flat.
Lexi, tell us something interesting.
Okay. The earth is flat, and a witch stole his pants.
Flat Earth expert Mark Sargent thinks the moon landing was a hoax.
Technically, the moon itself is a hoax.
Right, but betting with Sportsbet's new iPhone app?
I could do this standing on my head.
Thanks, gravity. Sportsbet's new iPhone app. It's foolproof.
Hold on. I know how we're different. Do you believe the Earth is flat?
I know it's flat. I walk on it.
Holy shit.
The Earth is flat.
It's a flat world after all.
Smoke weed every day. Hold up. Smoke weed every day. Hold up. Smoke weed every day. Hold up.
Smoke weed every day. Hold up. Und jetzt der Verkehr. Vorsicht, liebe Autofahrer, auf der A3 Oberhausen Richtung Arnheim ist die linke Spur aufgrund eines Zufuhrabsturzes gesperrt.
What in the holy heck is going on here with my sound?
Broadcasting straight to you from a large spaceship currently at war with mainstream science. Meanwhile, the peanut gallery is MIA. I have no idea where he is right now. So we're going to go with the default, which is no matter where you go, there you are. Who said that? Buckaroo Banzai. Hello, everyone, and welcome to Strange World, where the truth is often stranger than fiction. I'm your host, Mark Sargent, the creator of Flat Earth Clues, which propose that all of us are living inside a Truman Show enclosed structure thousands of miles wide. Just Google Flat Earth Clues. If you can't find it, well, you suck at the internet. Currently, this show is on Tuesday nights at 7 Pacific, 10 Eastern. And yes, Caroline, if it is not Better look at date because I just got back. Oh, wow. It's October 25th. Who knew? Then you are listening to a rerun. Quote of the day goes exactly like this one thing. I don't know half of you half as well as I should like, and I like less than half of you half as well as you deserve. Who said that? Bilbo Baggins. Yes, in the original Lord of the Rings, Fellowship of the Ring. My co-host, she's lovely, she's sassy, and you know what? She just pulled off the biggest Flat Earth event of the year, which I was at. Karen B. Hey, Karen.
Hi, Mark.
So you survived, and we're going to talk about it. We're going to spend the whole show reminiscing and talking to callers, hopefully, that went to the event, and some people that didn't but regret it. But before we get to that, Karen, being that you are now fully established as the Queen of Flat Earth.
Why do you say that? That makes me feel weird when people say that to me, and people say it all the time, but
that's weird. Good. That's good because you're humble. That means you're humble. I mean, oh, you know, other people like Shelley Lewis, she does good work, but you, Karen, you are a true leader in this community and must be treated as such. People should bow down. Yay, unwashed heathens. Bow down before the glory that is Karen B. Okay, it's enough sucking up for now. Hey, it must be hard to find Flat Earth friends, Karen. Do you know an easy way to find cool people like yourself and solid info about our stationary horizontal level plane?
Why, yes, that would be the Flat Earth Sun, Moon, and Zodiac Clock app.
Sure enough, it's the perfect gift for friends, family, and complete strangers. Become a blue dot. Yeah, I just thought of that just now.
I should
be getting royalties for that. Hear that, Weiss? Watch the feature video every day for 2 weeks and see what happens. It'll be the best $2.99 plus taxes you've ever spent.
And actually, the chat feature, the new chat on the app, is pretty cool. You can do video chats, group chats. It's actually a pretty cool chat. So yeah. I must say.
Nice. Yeah. Well, don't forget, you can also find this program on BitChute, Variety, on Rockfin, Rumble, and social media platforms that haven't even been invented yet. Plus, I'm pretty sure there's like 2 or 3 streams which are going straight to Langley, Virginia for safekeeping. YouTube is not the end of Flat Earth. It is just the beginning. No, I had friends that say, you know, we save all your freaking shows. It's like, yeah, I know. They laugh about it at the Christmas party. Shout outs. Got a few this way. We're not going to shout out everybody, obviously. Flat Earthers, Stephen Carpenter of the Deftones, support the Flat Earth cause and get the coolest hoodies ever. Go to the strong.family. But as Karen and I found out, and she might have one within reaching distance, just hoodies, folks. He's got a whole bunch of merch, and he sent a son. And by the way, Stefan, if you're listening, and you probably are, thank you for the mugs. Fantastic, high quality stuff. Yeti mugs.
Everybody loved the Yeti mugs.
Oh, yeah. No, I gave one to my mom, and she's going, wow, this thing is the most durable thing I've ever seen. She goes, I could drop it. I go, don't drop it.
And
she goes, the coffee's still hot. She's a big coffee person.
Yeah, it'll keep your coffee hot for hours.
Yes, it will. So yeah. So if you don't want hoodies, but you want a great mug, go pick up some Flat Earth mugs at the site built by Yeti. Good stuff. So did you get them all away to the people?
I did. I got rid of all of them.
Nice.
I gave everybody.
Who was supposed to get some.
Who was supposed to get some theirs. Yeah. And then I had some to give away, and I gave them away to various people at the event. Some of the people that worked, you know, some of the video guys, Nathan, the sound guy, you know, they all deserve it. So.
Oh, I bet, by the way, Nathan would have totally enjoyed it. Mm-hmm. And that's it's a good consolation for him because he wanted the magic hat. Thank you for everybody that participated in the raffle of the 32nd degree Mason hat from 1955. You know, there was only going to be one winner. And of course, the winner ended up being a Mason, which just
really,
yes,
that's so funny.
a guy comes up, the guy only bought two tickets, right? And I told other people, they're like they use some voodoo mamba pajamba, you know, hex on the thing, because you know, you saw me up there, right? I spun the thing, reached in blind, you know, backwards to grab the ticket. Guy only bought two tickets. He comes up to me later and he goes, a Mexican guy, and he goes, so I won the hat, right? He's showing me the hat. I go, yeah, it's great, fantastic. He goes, what's the story with it? I go, you didn't listen to my speech? He goes, no, I missed it. I go, why'd you buy the hat? You know, the tickets. He goes, oh, I saw you walking around with tickets, right? And like, all right. And not only that, right? Not only that, then I go, I told him the story. You know, my one grandfather was a Scottish Rite. My other one was a Templar. He goes, oh, I'm a Templar. I go, what? yeah, I'm a Templar. It's like, so this is actually, he goes, this will be in safe hands. And he winks at me. It's like, dude. And to add insult to injury, he goes, this is the first thing I've ever won in my life. What?
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
The guy had to have been at least pushing 40, as far as I can tell. It's like, you've never won anything and you win this hat. So anyway. Anyway, thank you to everybody. But of course, it was gonna be amazing. Space is fake. Oh.
I got this from Chief Crow.
Right. Very nice.
My new beer koozie, drink koozie.
Yeah, I got a chance to shake his hand after. Well, you know, we're getting ahead. Let me do the other shout outs really quick.
Okay, yes, definitely. Sorry,
because we'll be talking about this for a while. Also to Suzanne and Trismax. One delicious, ready, bite at a time. There's a story that goes with this. And by the way, Suzanne morsel. Was there.
It says morsel.
Yes, I know it does say morsel. You know the story behind this?
No, go ahead and tell it.
Oh God. So a fanboy comes up afterwards, a self-appointed fanboy. I believe his name is Rico. Comes up at, you know, after he pins me down, you know, in a chair, and he's talking. He goes, look, man, he goes, I don't want to come off, you know, telling you what to do, but there's some things that have been bothering me, and I'd hope you don't say them in the show. I go, what? He goes, something you say every show. And I go, what? He goes, morsel. I go, I say morsel in the show? He goes, yeah, every freaking week you say the word morsel. He goes, I don't like the word morsel. He goes, it's got like a round sound. He goes, like jumbo and boobs. I was going, what? He goes, I don't like round words like that. And I go, and so anyway, we got in this argument back and forth. It's like, I don't say the word morsel. You know, I got other people. It's like, yeah, listen to Mark. He probably doesn't say it. Turns out I have been saying morsel every week because I just pasted it in from Suzanne's thing. I actually like delicious bite. So as of now, I'm changing it. Because you know why? I lost a dollar to this guy.
Why did you lose a dollar?
Because I bet him that it wasn't morsel. And it was kind of like, you know, like when everyone's like a singer, when a fan comes up to him and says, dude, on this album, track 4, verse 3, you know, you say such and such. And then you're like, no, man, I totally don't say that. It's like, you absolutely, you know, he's got it memorized. And so
focus.
What? Oh, focus? Oh, the camera script?
Yeah.
All right. That's weird. We haven't had that in a while.
The focus
on. Okay. So that happens again. It's why I hold the microphone, because if I get a little animated and the camera doesn't know what to do with it. Anyway, so the dollar that you won off me, well played, and it will come up later because he actually sent me a meetup thing. And you might want to save that dollar. And I'm one of those weird people. And I know which dollar it is too. You know why? Because it has 888 in the serial number. Yeah, that's why I gave it to you. So don't lose it. I should have signed it. So anyway, there you go. Spreading truth, one delicious bite at a time. There you go. No more morsel.
Why? What's wrong with morsel?
You know, I like, because because I was so adamant about it. It's like, no, I'd say bite. I wouldn't say morsel. And that's actually true. If I wrote this, no offense to Suzanne from Truthmax, but I would say bite. I think it's an easier sort of, you know, it's a word that kind of sticks with you. Plus, I like biting. How's that? Whatever.
You're such a biter.
Don't judge me. Stupid head. Okay. Also, big shout out to, and you see the hat I'm wearing here. Yeah, right. It's a trucker's hat. Why am I wearing this Bolton's hat? Bolton's
Curbside Cookery.
Yep, Bolton's Curbside Cookery up in Mount Holly. They're really great. And, you know, I got to shoot the commercial. We'll talk about that in a second. Good people up the Boltons. And they're really nice. Yep, they came down with their family, spent the weekend. They went to the Friday, Saturday, and Sunday event, which we'll talk about.
Mm-hmm.
Jenny, anytime you want to leave Lee, bring the kids. Okay. Enough said. She's like packing right now. Lee, I'm out of here. You heard him. Okay. Let's do meetups real fast. Meetups. Do you have any meetups on your side? Are they still registering with you? I've got a couple.
I kind of got behind with the event, and
being that you were organizing an entire conference. Yeah, I figured you might.
I'm sorry, people.
Oh, please. Are you kidding? I just released our episode together when we were in the studio together last night at about midnight. And then the very next day I got to do a whole new show. So, anyway, so the meetups, let's do one real quick. First one is Jesse. He's going to do a meetup Saturday, November 5th from 6 to 9 at the Alley Bar and Grill in 11413 East 13th Street, North Wichita, Kansas. Please RSVP by calling Jesse at 857-344-6209 or email him at 300kmileprius@gmail.com. That's 300kmileprius@gmail.com. He'll have an icon. But you know what? While I'm reading that, it just occurred to me. Wait a minute. He just sent me a meetup thing, right? For a meetup he's doing in Kansas. This is Jesse. Well, Jesse wasn't there.
No.
What the hell, Jesse? You drive absolutely everywhere. You organize meetups. This would have been something you absolutely lived for. I want an email with an excuse. I do. It's like, okay, it's one thing to be like, oh no, I couldn't make it this or that. But don't tell me, I mean, what, the Friday thing was free. Don't tell me it was because of money. And you live in your car often. So
maybe you just wasn't feeling up to it. I don't know.
Yeah, but then to organize a meetup 2 weeks later, I think that's suspicious. But whatever, Jesse, I better get a follow-up email. You better let me know. No, and don't call. I don't want to hear it over the phone. I don't want to hear it on the phone lines. Just email me, whatever the hell happened. Also a last minute, meetup from Rico. hey man, it was great meeting you. Hot sex at Flattoberfest. He actually put that in the email. What a perfect weekend, huh? There you go. Perfect weekend. Want to announce, Dr. Law and himself are doing an impromptu meetup, subliminal message morsel, since he's coming my way anyway. Is it not too last minute? Could you do a promo for me? Yes, I can. It's going to be at Mi Cancun Mexican Restaurants in 536. And I put the promo up on my channel. Anon Springs Road in Smyrna, Tennessee. S-M-Y-R-N-A, Smyrna.
Mm-hmm.
That's got to be it. Saturday the 29th. So it's coming up in 4 days at 5 p.m. Central. So there you go. You can email him at staygoldrico. God. @gmail.com. That's staygoldrico@gmail.com. So he and Dr. Law are going to be doing that. So very, very cool. And that is all of the meetups. Normally I would promote Flattoberfest, but as you know, Karen,
we just had it,
and it was magical.
It was epic.
It was magic. Karen was a ball of stress for a while and then cut loose at the end with a bunch of fruity drinks. But
I wasn't too stressed out. It wasn't as bad as it has been in the past, but it was, you know, I still have to make sure everything goes correctly, you know.
That is true. Yeah.
You're still in charge.
You were very focused, and it was probably good. You don't want to be people looking for it. It's like, Karen, you got to get on top of this. I flew in on, as you guys know, let's do a quick recap. I flew in on Monday evening in the Boltons from Boltons Curbside Cookery. They picked me up at the airport and took me to an Airbnb. And it's like, oh, wonderful. An Airbnb for 4 nights. all by myself. Nope. Rick Hummer showed up the very next day. And he and I drove down, recap, to see Karen. And Karen and I did, apparently, from everyone told me, the best performance of our lives. We were live. Everybody, I mean, everybody said, dude, it was so great. You should move to the Carolinas. Like, God. And I was just praying that
a lot of people want to move here.
Yeah. I was hoping that some producer, I felt bad. I was one of the weird things that after I was done with you, Karen, I immediately felt regret because it was like, why? You know, it's like, if we would have been next to each other the entire time, it would have been awesome. We could have been doing this, but it was a blast. Loved it. And everyone reminded me of it. So thank you everybody for saying that. And even the audio version, they were saying, it was, you know, because we were, now again, part of it is because we were, you know, who knows, after we do it, if we did that for like 3-4 months, Karen would probably get tired of me. It's like, you're crowding me, you know, stop doing this, stop doing that. But the fact that we shared headphones, that was the best part, because we forced us to be like jammed up next to each other, like we were doing a podcast from a broom closet.
Yeah.
So that was very, very cool. And then Rick, of course, cuts it close. So yeah, I was there, what, 20 minutes before showtime. And then we went up back up to Mount Holly, and we shot the commercial with the Boltons on Wednesday night. And then Thursday we looked through the footage, and hopefully, you know, we made sure that we didn't have to do follow-ups. And then Friday morning we drove down to, what park was that anyway?
That's Herd Klotz Park. It's right across the street from the Shrine Club.
Awesome. And that, yeah, and that was perfect. Absolutely a perfect place. And we, a lot of people there, and the group shot was fantastic. And quite a few people there, of course, that, you know, because it was free. You know, if you didn't want to pay the $80 a day to do the conference, you could do that. You know, you do it. And Dr. Law was there, and there was food, and there was drinking, and there was some music and all sorts of fun little activities, and people took pictures. There was drone footage. It was awesome. Met a lot of people. And my only complaint was I was dodging bees.
Were you?
Good Lord. I don't know what it was. They weren't on me as much as other people, but there was several types of bees that were hunting me. Maybe they know, you know, bees know fear, and I don't like bees. Not a bee guy, but that was super fun, and people stayed late, and then went over to the bar below the Shriners Club. Oh, and there was karaoke.
Yes, so, karaoke. Yes, so, for sure.
Yes. So initially, the bar below the Shriners Club, everyone was making fun with everybody. Rick Hummer couldn't pry him away, and then there was karaoke. Dr. Law, of course, and I am embarrassed, but I fessed up to him. I went out and I told him, I had no idea. When he calls into the show and he does an Elvis impersonation, I thought it was just some little thing he does. I didn't realize he wears the full-blown Vegas jumpsuit and the sunglasses, you know, thank you very much. And does the whole thing. And he's quite good.
Yeah.
He is quite good. You know, when I was walking, because, you know, Rick goes, oh, you can drive, you know, because Rick wasn't driving. You know, he's like, find the car. You can go back to the hotel. It'll be fine, man. I'll get a ride. He never did get a ride. He got an Uber. And I remember when I was walking, looking for the car next to the Shriners Convention, I was hearing Dr. Law, but it was so good. It sounded like a pro, you know, we're caught in a trap. Get out. Yeah, it was awesome. He was very, very good. And you know, so how did you stay for the whole karaoke thing, or just some of it?
I don't know if I stayed for all of it, but I stayed for a while.
Did you sing?
I did not. I did not sing this year.
Did you sing last year?
Yeah, I did. Me and Law did a song last year.
That's awesome.
Well, no, not last year. When was that? That was a while ago. I think that maybe that was Solar Return.
Yeah,
it was Solar Return.
Nice.
Because we weren't at the Shrine Club last year. We were at the Magnolia Grand, which they didn't have the karaoke there. But
yeah, which you seem to not enjoy as much. I did not see it, but everybody else told me it's like, oh yeah, this is way better for this.
Yeah, it is.
Sort of event.
it's better, it's got more room. You know, with how our people are and how they all just want to have the freedom to go in and out and hang out and just kind of, you know, be loud and do whatever. I mean, that's what they want to do. They want it because, you know,
other places they, not as much, not as much. No, this place, I mean, you could, short of actually, you know, shooting each other in the parking lot, cops are never showing up at this place. It's never happened.
Club. Dude, nobody messes with the Masons.
No, they don't. We could have taken, and we'll talk about it, we could have thrown those protester kids, we could have thrown them into vans. No one would have figured that out for a long time. Could have driven them out of the woods and just left them there.
They could have just, you know, tied them up to the telephone pole on the other side of the parking lot.
Good hope. We will talk about that when we get back. We didn't actually tie up the kids or anything like that. But, well, I don't think they'll be coming back anytime soon. We're going to go to our first break. And when we come back, we're going to talk a little bit more about the conference. And then we're going to take your phone calls. Please, anyone that wants to call in and talk about their time there or why you didn't go, because I'd like to hear it, honestly. So the phone number, of course, is 848-222-2480. That's 848-222-2480. Karen, drop a beat, won't you? I've got so much street cred.
All love the Flat Earth Sun, Moon, and Zodiac Clock app, the best tool to show your friends and strangers how the Flat Earth actually works. But are you ready for a Flat Earth app game changer? A new feature has been added. But first, a reminder of some of the existing features. Video of the day. World time. See what time it is all around the Flat Earth. A true Earth compass that shows true navigation across and around the flat Earth plane. Weather. Tap for detailed local weather information. Know what phase and where the moon is at all times. Watch the sun travel between the tropics for the seasons. Select an amazing background. Add a countdown to your next big date. Video playlists in different languages. See the real trade winds circling the flat Earth. Top 21 frequently asked questions with quick pop-up video answers. Access to the best photos and gifts at your fingertips. Flat Earth books and merchandise and more. Now, the game changer upgrade we've always dreamed of having.
Shout out to Karen B, Mark Sargent, David Weiss. I'll be checking out that video this weekend at the Flat Earth, Sun, Moon, and Zodiac Clock app on YouTube. Or
join me, Karen B. Every moon day.
Every moon day.
9:30 a.m. Eastern on Rockfin, Twitch, and Facebook.
Are you making fun of me, Mark?
For an early light chit chat. Open phones, open topics. Always chill. I hope to see you there.
Welcome back to Strange World, part 2 of 4. It's you, me, Karen B. And you know what? That was Joe Jackson stepping out from his album.
Night and Day.
Yep. So we are going to take calls, but I want to continue a little bit of the wrap up because there was a lot of fun things that happened during this this conference, and I get so sad I missed the last one. But you know what? It was the return of Mark Sargent, and I was glad I opened. We opened a little bit late. Love the fact that again. Okay, first off, I want to say, you know, because Rick doesn't listen to the show. Rick Hummer, who did the emceeing officially for Dallas and Raleigh and Denver and other stuff. Rick Hummer is probably the most creative man I've ever met in my life. He's just amazing, amazing guy. Overall, it's just, his mind is just constantly going, going, going. But we were supposed, you know, that we show up on Saturday to you know, get ready for the opening, and everyone's staying outside. The door's locked.
Mm-hmm.
And Rick's like, and Rick had spent most of that earlier evening drinking with the Masons and was pretty sure he was, it's like, oh, dude, we are in with these guys. It's like, I know all of them. Yeah. I know the Lodge Master. I know. It's like, we're best friends. Right. And I'm going, okay, that still doesn't help. It's like, I'll get us in there. Right. And he goes down. Next thing you know, he's pulling open the bay doors. It's like, wow, that's incredible, man. Did you find the Lodge Master? He's like, no. No, I kicked the door in. We're going to have to go to Home Depot and get some lumber because I'm pretty sure the frame is busted. It's like, what? He's going, it's okay, man. We're in with these guys. I can totally smooth it over with him. He wasn't lying, but it was just, you know, that's him. It's like, you know, just focus. It's like, oh, yeah, these guys need to get in. I'm going to break the door down to do it. It's like, dude. Oh my God. And my point is, I had to bunk with him for 6 straight nights. This guy, right? And it only got worse because we had the Airbnb, you know, us, and you know, it was a 3-bedroom, and at least we got our rooms, thank God. We shot the commercial, you know, he was just buzzing, 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 buzzing. And then we get, there's this one decisive moment where I'm at the hotel. Hell, you were there when it happened. He was disappointed because his wife apparently screwed up the hotel reservations. He was supposed to stay in the hotel that we were at. And he goes, oh, Tab screwed up the reservations. He goes, I'm going to be at a hotel 15 minutes away. And I'm going, oh, I'm going to regret this. And it's like, hey, Rick, there's 2 beds in my room. You want one of them? It's like, you know, I was like, I couldn't impose, man. I couldn't do it. I can't. He's like, no. And like, and then, you know, it's like, no, be no trouble at all. Really. And he's like, oh, dude, you totally saved me. Yep. So then the next 3 nights in the same room with him. Thank God he had his own car and he could come and go as he pleased. And he was very respectful. You know, he'd come in and try to be ultra, ultra quiet. I actually watched him on the top of his tiptoes, walking in slow motion, trying to be quiet. Oh, God.
Rick was having a blast.
Yeah. And then leaving. If you get a chance, next time you talk to David, because, you know, David Weiss was there. Didn't present, but he was there in full effect. And he talked to a whole bunch of people, Dave and Paige.
Mm-hmm.
And it was like, I didn't know that David got a ride down to the thing. And so when Rick hears this, right, it's like, oh yeah, by the way, we're driving Dave and Paige up to the thing. We went the wrong way, I think 4 or 5 times in the first 5 minutes. You know, going on, you know, Rick's looking at the, you know, the GPS, like, this thing's screwed up. I don't know what's going on. It's like, you're not even looking at it. What are you doing? You're just driving in circles. So it was an interesting drive up to the airport, and then we, you know, took our separate ways, but it was awesome. Absolutely awesome. Also, side note, my first time getting a chance to talk to crap. Now I'm embarrassed because he's probably listening right now. Marty Leeds.
Marty, yeah.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
You mean in real life?
In real life. We've done a couple things, video things, but we never talked in real life. It was awesome. It was great. Really, we talked in the lobby before his set, and I sat down and listened to his set, and it was very interesting. And we talked a little bit afterwards, and it was awesome. Got to meet his, is it his wife or his girlfriend?
It's his wife.
Well, no, I didn't mean that those were separate things. Oh, crap. Now I'm just blowing him out of the water. It's like, no, I'm sure it was his wife. His girlfriend has nothing to do with it. That's a completely separate person. But that was a lot of fun. Dr. Law did an amazing job with food and the Kakalaki crew. I don't have my shirt with me, but they made me an honorary member.
Yes.
Which was great. And I partook of... I didn't know they did brunch. I knew we did brunch and burgers and I had their fried rice later. Delicious.
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely awesome. But it was the event. Your best move, Karen, was that back room. That's what really made the difference.
Yeah.
That room where all the vendors got to set up and that's people just, so there were like three staging areas. It was like any given moment. Yeah. There were people listening to stuff, the speakers, but it was more, you know, still that social situation. So people socialized out front,
mm-hmm.
with, you know, in the front steps, in the lobby. Some people, I swear, they just lived out there. I think it was people there that had no intention of going to the conference. They came to the park and then just hung out on the front steps. Like those, you saw those four comfy chairs on the front steps. Those chairs were constantly, you know, some people were camping in those things, you know, for hours at a time. The middle room with the vendors was awesome. And I have to fess up to you, when those kids, so people don't know this, but we had some high school protesters. We don't know from what high school they were from. They were, you know, just trolls, you know, little wannabe nothings.
Wannabe trolls. Yes.
Wannabe trolls. And they showed up to the, they showed apparently on Friday. I never saw them, or Saturday, but they set up a table on Sunday. And I walk up to Karen because I saw him out of the corner of my eye, right? And, you know, I was walking in the door and I was going, huh? And I told Karen, I go, wow, it's pretty bold, those trolls out there, you know, out the parking lot. You go, what are you talking about? And I go, you know, the ones that set up a table. You're like, set up a table? I could see like a vein in your head. You know, it's like, Ted, you know, and then you led me. What did you do? I didn't see what you did to them, you know, because they were out there with their little folding table and trying to shoot video with an Xbox.
I went out there with a bunch of dudes and I told them to take their stuff across the street. I'm like, get this out of here. You guys got to go across the street. Get out of the parking lot. Go away. They're like, can we just go over there? I'm like, no, get your ass across the street. Get out of here.
Was it true that you guys picked up the table and were like carrying it away for them?
Yeah.
Nice. Nice. They look so young. It's like, yeah, they different from the Peter Jarvio people. Oh yeah, let me mention this really quick. You know, Peter Jarvio, the street activist extraordinaire who goes to campuses, he was at Clemson all week during the week, Monday through Thursday, and I'll be damned if I didn't have four Clemson people show up at the Friday event and talk to me. Two groups of two guys separately. You know, one during, you know, when the sun was still up and one sun was down, they found me. It's like, oh, where are you guys from? Oh yeah, Clemson. You know, asking good questions. You could tell they weren't trying to, you know, nobody was filming anything. It was like, yeah, awesome. So I got to talk to them. So good for you, Peter. What else? Do you have any special fun moments that you looked? It's like, yeah, you know, this was kind of cool.
It was cool to meet Josh from Founded Earth Brothers showed up. So I hadn't met him before. So it was nice to meet him. And it was cool that also the Project 314 people showed up.
Yeah.
Which I thought was cool with their model, their dome model of the tabernacle thing. I thought that was cool. And I loved seeing the How the World Works exhibit where Zach and Cammy had all their stuff. They were just swamped the entire time.
Nice.
Just swamped. And they had tons of these little packages they had put together to give away for all the children. I think they gave almost all of them away to every child there. So Everybody that went to their table got, you know, got a little lesson on natural physics and how it works on the flat Earth. So that was my favorite, was seeing how busy they were the whole time. And that was another reason why I got that second room, because I wanted them to be able to just talk and talk and talk as much as they wanted, because people go there and ask so many questions and they get to ask them directly.
Yes.
Right. So yeah. That was one of my favorite things too.
Yeah, that middle room, it took away from the you know, the chair area and the speakers, but at the same time, that's half the reason people go there. It's like they you want to listen to speakers, but you want to talk to your everyone in our peer groups, and it's awesome. Now that middle room was jammed sometimes. I mean, just wall to wall people.
Yeah.
I got lucky because that back corner where you set up the banner and the lights, people kept thinking that was like a sacred place. So no one was doing anything there. So I just camped. I sat there for hours, and people would come over and they swore that, you know, because there's lights and a poster behind, they swore there were cameras. I was going, there's no cameras.
No, there were, but Brian and David,
a mobile camera. Yes.
We're using it to do interviews every now and then. So
yeah,
it's fine. It's fine that people stayed out of that area. There was plenty of other place for them to go anyway.
Yeah, so. Very, very true.
It worked out.
Yeah, it was awesome all the way around. Oh, I'm sorry. One more thing. On top of the musical groups, and by the way, I got to briefly chat with Chief Crow, which was kind of fun. Media Clown,
right? Media Bear.
Media Bear.
Well, it's Media Bear, and then he dresses up as Dr. Clown.
Okay, so it's Dr. Clown, but as a But one of his handles is Media Bear. Got it.
Yes.
He interviewed me for a while, which was kind of fun.
There you go.
And walking him, you know, watching him go around and then get in on the band action was great. He seemed to have fun. I don't think his daughter, I'm assuming that was his daughter, she does not look like she was having a good time. He's like, just make sure the cameras don't get knocked over. Like, she's just sitting there on her phone. But he was great. He was absolutely awesome. And hopefully he caught in the live stream when he was talking to me. Dave Weiss figured out where his field of vision was. You don't have much peripheral when you're wearing that mask. So he was like coming up behind. He was video bombing in the back, and he never saw it. And I'm trying to keep a straight face. And David's like, oh, yeah. And he made me like left. And I'm sure later in the footage or maybe the chat room figured it out. But yeah. Great, wonderful, Karen. You did a fantastic job. It was a great, great thing. And whatever you do in the future, wherever it is, I'm sure will be stellar, because you've got a handle. You have a nat. You're natural for this.
Well, thank you. Yep. Thank you, Mark.
Yep. Sorry, you had to be so stressed as much as you were, but at the same time, that's part of it.
But it really, you know, it is part of it. That's part of why, you know. I know. I mean, that's just part of.
Yeah,
comes with doing these things, but I, you know, it all works out.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I mean,
I still enjoy it, because I still get to do. I guess still get to talk to people, and I still get to see everybody else having a good time, and that's really kind of what gets me through it. Even though it is stressful, is I see everybody else having fun, and that makes me feel good. It makes me feel good to see everybody else enjoying themselves.
Yeah,
you know. Because that's what I'm doing it for. So as long as I see that what I'm doing is actually the purpose is being served, and what I want to happen is happening, that the stress is worth it.
Yeah. And to your point, and I said this to many, many people, is like, find me a frowny face other than Dr. Clown's daughter, you know, who really wasn't even part of it. Everybody that came in, and the people in the lobby, just the happiest faces, and you know, everyone was just so there was just so much positive energy everywhere. And you know, whoever you bumped into, they're your friend, right? A lot of hugging. And I know it's the cliche, you know, part of it's the cliche conference thing, you know, all conventions, you know, turn into parties. But you know what, when it comes to that, Flat Earth represents. Flat Earth party. It's like, you've heard, it's like, oh, you're like a Shriners convention. No. Shriners convention.
Yeah.
No. Flat Earthers put those guys to freaking shame. You know, they, I mean, because everything closes and we're still there. That's the part. It's like, you know, doors are closed. There's still, you know, bars are closed. Things are locked up. No. We're going to, if there's a building still standing and there's light, they're going to be still, sun's coming up. Okay. Maybe now we have to go to bed. But it was awesome. I, like Rick was telling me, you know, Rick, he closes things and I'm going, was there anybody left? He's going, dude, he's going, there's like 30 something people there when I left. For no reason. They were just there.
Yeah, there was a bunch of people hanging out for a while. They're having a good time, yeah, you know? Yeah.
So in the future, if anyone, and we'll now take some phone calls, you go to because you want to be with people of a like mind. And this is it. I mean, you go and you, there's no judgment. You know, everyone in the room is on the same page with you. Maybe not on every little thing, but it doesn't matter. You're all, you know, comrades in arms. You're all allies in this thing. And it was great. You know, I so much love everywhere. And so for everyone I met, everyone I took pictures with, everything else, fantastic. I enjoyed meeting every one of you. And I hope you email me. Do hesitate to call though. So we're going to go to the board and I'm kidding. You can call me. In fact, again, my phone, people are so shy. My phone does not, you know, my phone's right here. It's not on mute. My phone does not blow up as much as you guys might think it does.
Mm-hmm.
I do texts and emails quite a bit, but all right, we are going to go to the phone lines. The phone number, of course, is 848-222-2480, 848-222. That's the wrong phone. I don't even know how you got that. That is not a number that I give out. That's probably something else. Don't worry about it. It's probably just the agency. Let's go to someone who was there, guaranteed. We'll pick up him first. Ready?
Mm-hmm.
We're going to go out to 646. What's happening out there? Alex, I know you're there. Say something.
Hello?
He's probably not saying something because of the crap he gave me for talking all week. Or he's on mute. Or he went to the bathroom. Or he fell off his balcony. All right, Alex, I'll get back to you. That's weird.
Alrighty then.
You're in there, right? Yeah, you're in there.
Yeah.
Peanut doesn't have to do anything. It's just you and me.
No.
All right.
Alex is not working.
All right. Well, let's find out. Let's go to New Mexico. 505. It's you, me, and Karen B. Can you hear the words that are coming out of my mouth?
I can. Loud and clear, Mark and Karen. You sound great.
Cool. What's happening, man?
Hey, by the way, I have to mention this first. That pre-show, just a few minutes before this show started, that was pretty funny. I don't know what was going on there, but... was that like a family member, Karen?
No.
Oh boy.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was my mom.
I would. Okay. That was pretty entertaining, I must say, and I should have tuned in earlier because I don't know what I missed before that. But yeah, that was a great pre-show.
Oh man, and I didn't start recording till after that.
Yeah.
Damn it.
Yeah, you missed it, Mark.
Yeah, so that won't be on tomorrow's or tonight's thing when I put it up online.
No. Had to be there to get it.
Yep. What else you got? Yep.
Well, you know, Mark, I was you quoted Bilbo Baggins from The Hobbit earlier.
Yep.
And that got me thinking about what I really love about Flat Earth is the constant rewiring that you have to do with subjects or interests that were way before Flat Earth.
Right.
And when you mentioned that quote, it made me think of Tolkien's Middle Earth concept.
Yeah.
And, oh, man, it's been probably almost 40 years since I read, you know, The Lord of the Rings and The Hobbit. But
sure.
I don't remember. I seem to recall that maybe he had a map of Middle Earth and maybe one of them. But I didn't have time to look it up. But do you think that he was did he have some kind of, you know, maybe Flat Earth, kind of Middle Earth being in Flat Earth, kind
no.
of like the Japanese map with the extra couple.
No, with Tolkien, it was just that because it was a fantasy world, it didn't have to be a globe because he was just starting out, you know, back in the day, you know, when you're just building the continents, you don't know what the world looks like. So with his, it's like, well, you know, it was Middle Earth and then some oceans, you know, with dragons. or whatever. And so no, he just built us, you know, it's kind of like, again, what we do when we design, you know, any fantasy story or game or whatever it is, you know, you just draw out the map. It's like, here is, you know, all the story takes place within these borders and that's it. I'm not going to define what's outside these borders because I'm too busy trying to build you the world that's inside these borders, but it is a flat world inside Middle Earth. Absolutely.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, no, thanks for bringing that up. And that brings me another question. Did you folks ever play Dungeons and Dragons because of the influence of Tolkien and his books?
I didn't, but that's only because in the 80s, kids that played D&D were considered fringe weird. You know, people didn't quite understand it. And there were some people that tried to tie demonic things to D&D, a lot of that. So they were a clique that only later I was going, wow, had I known then what I know now, I would have been in that group in 2 seconds, because I was a huge D&D when D&D transferred over to video, you know, and computers. It was like, oh yeah, I was all over. I was a big, real quick, I was a big Magic the Gathering fan back in the day. The okay. card game was out. It was awesome. And to this day, I still, you know, I mean, Tolkien, of course, D&D doesn't happen without Tolkien. Warcraft doesn't happen without that. Tolkien inspired so much. So many things. Well, hell, Star Wars, Return of the Jedi, Return of the King. Yeah, not a coincidence in the slightest.
Yeah, that's right. I never thought about that relationship between Star Wars and Tolkien. Yeah.
Oh, no. Tolkien inspired everything. I had a friend who was a huge Tolkien guy. He's going, no. Everybody ripped off Tolkien, because why not? I mean, when he was doing it, fantasy wasn't even, it was barely a concept. So, yeah. Anyway, anything else?
Yeah. No, that's pretty much it. I'll let you guys get to the calls. And let's see. The only thing I remember just from Lord of the Rings, I'll throw this at you. I think it was the last line in Two Towers.
Yeah.
Frodo was alive, but taken by the enemy. So that's my quote to you. And shout out to you and Karen and everybody at Flat Soberfest, and of course Jan in Dallas. Have a great night. Keep it flat.
All right, thanks, man.
Thank you.
All right, so let's go down to possibly Indiana. 765. You're on with Karen B. And Mark as a sidekick. What's happening?
Hey. What's up, Mark?
Hey. What's going on with you?
No, not much, man. This is Eldon from Indiana. I've been listening to you for a long fucking time, man, but first time caller.
Really? How long you been listening?
Yeah. Oh, man, for a minute. I've been listening to the YouTube deal like every Wednesdays for a couple of years.
Nice. Awesome. What's on your mind? Just calling in to say hi.
Well, yeah. Hi, everybody. Karen B.
Hi.
Deftones is my shit.
Right on. Nice.
No, I got a question about the stars, man.
All right.
All right, David Weiss. He says, when he went up into a plane, he couldn't see the stars when he got up there.
Right.
Because it was at night. But, like, what if it's a projection, like, from the inner, like the north? You know what I mean?
Sure. If it's projection, then it's possible that, depending on how high you are, you know, a plane, as it gets higher, would, you know, you would see fewer stars potentially. Sure. It's happened to me. I used to do business travel for years, and I looked outside and it's like, wow, you know, it's midnight, I'm flying in a very dark area of the country, and I'm looking out the window, for my eyes are more than adjusted, and I saw not very many stars. So I'm not gonna shoot down that theory.
Yeah. Well, anyways, I'll let you guys go. Keep doing what you guys are doing, man. You guys are great.
Thanks, man.
Thank you.
Appreciate it. Have a good one.
Yep.
right. Bye-bye.
You too.
Side note, Rick Hummer is from Indiana.
Yes, he is.
He probably knows that guy. Not kidding. He probably does. Let's go to... Oh, actually, we probably have to go to a second break, don't we?
Yes, it is time for second break.
It's time for second break, not to be confused with second breakfast, which is very Tolkien. When we come back, we will take phone calls. Hey, Karen, drop that sick beat, yo. So I was told, no, that's wrong. I was instructed by Karen B to do a commercial for Truth Smacks. So this is it. So yeah, Truth Smacks, Trail Mix Supreme. This is the Freedom version. Spreading truth one delicious morsel at a time. Yeah, there's a QR code on the back. You probably can't see it very well here, so maybe Karen will put it up on the screen here. Karen, maybe you heard a nice ding sound to it, like here, ding, or here, but not in front of my face. It's in front of
my
face, isn't it?
I actually didn't, because I slept all day today.
I figured. That's why I'm saying it.
And then I was going to do it.
While it's blocking my face, I'll read the ingredients. There's walnuts, pumpkin seeds, dark chocolate, cashews.
All right, I'm just letting you know so you don't look at it. Like,
no, salt, I know.
Raisins, dates, peppermint.
I can just tell everybody, sorry,
and one
there.
Thing that was left
just,
out, which is truth.
One more time.
Fine.
So, yeah. Truth Max. And see what I did there in front of my face now. So you came.
Is there another Flatoberfest?
Whoever's editing this. Wait, you're showing the bag, aren't you?
No, I should. I need to.
See? No, that's the QR code. Let's try it again. Yeah?
Maybe I
no?
Can.
This is what happens when you don't do all of your own work. You record something and you hope it's going to turn out well and you hand it over to the editors and they completely botch
it.
Up.
We need to give.
That's it.
Truth
Max.
To shout out the Thames, the true
one morsel
true
at a time.
Mount Moriah.
Oh, right.
Quiet. Support flat earth people. Thank you.
I can still play it now. You know how awesome it is to have these songs on here.
Bohemian, I drink the juice, the chocolate milk, the holy cow, I wear the sneaks, tip up the beak, I'm a 33.
Welcome back to Strange World, part 3 of 4. And yeah, that was Chief Crow and the Flat Earth Worms. And I got a chance to see him live, which was awesome. Right. Very, very cool. Went up after the show and told him that I'm in a Cult is an amazing song, and it is. I never get tired of it. It's so original. This guy, and the sound is really cool. And what watching him on stage, he's awesome.
Yeah.
He's really, really good. He's into it.
Tons of fun.
A bunch of important numbers.
That's right. 11, 33.
You know them all?
Yeah, no, he says a bunch. He says weird numbers. He says like 5, 23.
I think he like changes it up for a performance.
42.
He mentions he's thinking of breaking into Renaissance fairs because it would make sense because during the Renaissance, it was flat.
Yeah. Everybody thought the earth was flat.
So they should be just going right along with it.
Right?
Like a flat earth band? Of course. Of course there'd be a flat earth. Seriously, that's genius.
It is genius. Yeah. He's a smart guy. But you know, that's how it is with musicians when they're like that level of musicianship.
Yeah.
You have to be intelligent, you know?
Yeah.
Music like that.
Yeah. A loose garage band only goes so far.
Right.
You know, eventually you've got to be, you've got to know what you're doing. All right, let's go to, oh crap, where did I leave off? I already picked up Indiana.
CD.
The what?
This is the Chief Crow. This is his new CD. Oh, whoops, it's upside down.
Very nice. Very, very cool. I like it.
Mm-hmm.
I like it. Let's go to, we're going to jump around a little bit. I'm sorry, we're going to be out of order, guys. But we got to pick up this guy because he kept me fed the entire time. That's right. Elvis impersonator extraordinaire, Dr. Law, also known as Lavis.
Lavis. Thank you. Thank you very much.
I have a whole new appreciation for Mark. You, man.
I can't believe you missed it. That was my last performance ever.
What?
Hey, I just wanted to shout out Queen Bee for holding one of the best Flattoberfest ever. And I'm hoping the next one will be great. But I wanted to shout out our crew, the Kakalaki crew, everyone who knows who they are. Without them, I could not have done what I envisioned that we could do as a community. For people in our community who are in need, we raised $1,500 for a couple of people who really needed the money.
Mm-hmm.
We also helped Suzanne sell some of her products through Smacks. You know, we also got Gail, the masseuse, some money for gas as well. So in total, so far we've raised over $5,000 in all the events that you've allowed us to do, Karen. And I really, really appreciate that. And also, on a lighter note, I spent a few hours with Peter Jarvio today at my alma mater at the University of South Carolina.
Oh, awesome.
And he is exceptional. He is very exceptional at captivating the students there, interaction with them, flat smacking the hell out of them. I videotaped a couple hours of his flat smacking. I'm going to give it to maybe Tommy, that flat fellow, see if he can put things together and put it out on his channel so people would get to know Peter a little bit more. He is doing things that all of us in our own way could be doing to awaken the sheeple.
Sure.
We just had dinner. I'm going to make him some tea tonight and let him have it on the way home. But again, my biggest surprise of the Flattoberfest was meeting Rick Hummer. That guy is amazing.
Yeah.
As well as everyone else, of course. You know, mm-hmm. But Rick is he is the life of the party for sure.
Yeah.
Yep. and Rick's been doing. Rick's been with us since the beginning, and I always knew he was something special. The first second I met him in a hotel room with Matt Long and Raleigh, and it's like, you know, you could just see in the twinkle in his eye. It's like, oh yeah, this guy. You know, he's not much is going to get him down.
Absolutely, this guy, he is the life of the party. But you know, for everyone else that I've met, it was like meeting them all over again. I wished Sarah and Griff were there, because Griff was under the weather.
Yeah,
but we missed them. But also thank you very much, Mark, for putting out the promo. I will be up in Nashville with Smyrna, Tennessee, with Rico,
yep,
in foil, suave, sombrero, doing a meetup at a restaurant. So if anyone's around the area, please come out. I'd love to meet, you know, my Flat Earth brothers up there on Saturday. And I've got nothing else, guys. Queen Bee, thanks again. Thank you. From everyone in the community, I just want to say that we had a blast. And for those who couldn't make it, I was really saddened. And those who wouldn't make it, I'm deeply saddened, because you missed out on one of the greatest weekends of this year. We would have welcomed everyone in with open arms, put all our differences aside, as you would have seen, and had a great time.
Yeah.
So other events that Queen Bee may be throwing together, I invite all of you to come out. It's for us, okay? Thank you very much, guys. I love you guys. Love all of you in the chat, who's listening, who's a flat earther. No matter our differences, we're still people. Don't be a sheeple, okay? Love you guys. Talk to you later.
Thanks.
See you. See you. Oh, that was nice.
He's the best.
Yeah, he's a great guy. All right, jumping back up the list. I think we've already earmarked this one, but we're picking them up anyway. 864.
I bet you heard it. Together. Just, what's up?
Hey, Jack.
I have a little bit of laryngitis. I am a little tired from yesterday. We did some flat knocking in downtown Greenville, and if anybody knows the way that I do activism, I am the megaphone. So I was yelling across Greenville down at the park and
11,
at the Bowman 11. Amphitheater in Greenville, and people on the other side of the park could hear me, and they were all in pain because I was destroying their ball.
Aww.
What do you know about that?
Only you could do it. Were you wearing your lab coat?
Say again?
Were you wearing your lab coat?
I was for a part of it. Yes, I was. It did get really hot yesterday, which was kind of hard. We actually got the police called on us and
really?
Said that I was being offensive. Yeah. I was being super offensive, and I guess I could be arrested for being offensive now. That's a thing now. That's what they told me anyway. But yeah, they're like, you can't call people names and use cuss words and blah, 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 blah. But I know the thing that they called on me about was I said that the globe model purports to have air pressure next to a vacuum that defies physics. That's freaking retarded. And so since I said the word retarded, you know, 11-11, I got called. So, you know, that's what it's about.
Right.
Yeah, it's 11-12 now. I said 11-11 when we first started the call.
Yeah, one of my clocks says 11-11.
Anyway. So there, you can be arrested for being offensive now and saying that's retarded.
Yes.
Well, that's fucking retarded.
Yeah.
I mean, Stefan's going to jail.
What a rebel.
Nice.
So, yeah, check this out. So one cop was like really rude, you know, didn't want to talk to me. You know, every time he said something, I had some kind of rebuttal. He's like, can you just be quiet and let me talk? So I was quiet for a while and I let him talk. And then when he was done talking, when he was done with his statement, you know, I guess he was waiting for me to reply. So I just turned my head and I said, show me the curve. Show me the spin. Show me a vacuum that holds air in. Mm-hmm. And yeah, he walked away mad. And then the other cop, though, was like, yeah, you know, you're well within your rights, First Amendment. You should absolutely be doing this. You know, maybe you could just move a little further away from the restaurant. I'm like, yeah, no problem. So I went up on the bridge and started yelling there. That guy actually stuck around and listened to the whole explanation of Flat Earth while talking to Critical Inception. And yeah, totally had his back. And I think Critical Inception wants to share that story. Here you go.
Hey, everybody. Hey, Karen. Hey, Mark.
Hey, man.
So, yeah. Yeah, it was pretty amazing because the cop was looking at Jack's flyer that he made, and when he saw the curvature math, like his face just lit up like, whoa, that makes sense. And I started explaining it to him, and then there was a guy who came back. He was upset at me for saying that the globe is like Santa Claus for adults. And I said that Santa Claus isn't real in front of his children. And he was like, if that cop wasn't there, I'd kick your ass. And the cop had to pull him away and be like, whoa, you can't make threats like that.
And I said, Santa Claus ain't real. Neither is the Easter Bunny Tooth Fairy or anything like that. I hate that parents lie to their children.
But yeah, it was awesome because like that really, it really opened that cop's eyes because after he, you know, move that rowdy guy away. He came back to me. He's like, what was that about? Like, why are people getting so upset about this? And I explained to him, dude, people don't like the truth and we are here to spread the truth and they just don't want to hear it. So like the demons come out of them and, you know, so the cop got to see that up close and personal, what it's like to get flat smacked. And it was just such an amazing experience. I recommend next year that everybody come out for activism as always.
Well done.
And back to check.
Well done.
Yeah, so, I'm talking about, you know, activism, what we did yesterday, it was yesterday, right? Yeah. Dude, I don't even know what day it is anymore. I had a week of Saco, which is party every day, drink every night. Then I jumped right into Flat Tower Fest, which was really boring and annoying. No, I'm just kidding. It was a freaking blast. But it wears you out, man. I'm just... like, you know, my mind is fried, but my spirit is high, man. It's so great. And Karen B, thank you for doing it once again. And a conversation we had in the bar, we need to talk about that some more. That's all I got to say about that. I love you guys.
All righty.
Thanks, Jack. Appreciate you a whole bunch. Jack's gone. All right. Let's go out to the other side of the country. We don't get a lot of calls from Everett, Washington. I'm going to pick this up. 425, what's happening, man?
Well, hey there, Mark.
Hey.
Just wanted to welcome you back to the Northwest.
Thank you.
This is Steve up in Anacortes.
Oh, hey, Steve. What's going on?
Hi. Nothing much, man. This is my first time calling in, and y'all picked me up. I'm impressed.
Well, I saw your name, and I've got your GPS coordinates, and... hey, yeah, you're gonna have to stay on the line with me because it's gonna take 4 minutes for the drone to show up. The no, seriously, man.
Oh, you're not gonna show up here, are you?
No, not me. The drone will. And honestly, you're probably not gonna hear it when it happens. What's going on?
Oh, it's okay. We've got rifles here. We're all right. You know what? I just wanted to mention a couple of things. Yeah. Thank you so much for taking my call.
Oh, yeah, of course.
Okay. I got to watch you and Karen's in studio earlier today.
Right.
And you guys' energy is so freaking awesome. Either you should have dragged her back here from North Kakalaki or you should have stayed there. One of the two.
Oh, the first option would have actually technically been kidnapping. So okay, look, I got nothing against kidnapping, but I trust me when I say I was absolutely, even though my energy levels were so great when I left, when I got back to the Airbnb up in North Carolina, I was sad because I realized, like, oh, wow. When you know that when you do a team up and everything's clicking and you realize it's like, oh, we're in the wrong place at the wrong time because, you know, we're on opposite ends of the country. Yeah. But, hey, at least you guys got to see it. It's like, you ever want to know? We pulled it off, which is like, you know, Karen and I in the same room.
Oh,
also, again,
it was amazing. And yeah,
thank you.
I really wish I'd have been there for the Flattoberfest. Couldn't make it this year, but it sounds like an amazing, amazing event. And I just can't wait to go.
Yeah. Yeah. It was about as seamless as you get. The weather was great. There was no audio technical issues that I could really see. The people were good. The incidents were minor. You know, we had some protesters, but we chased them off and then tied them to a tree with duct tape. Yeah. And I mean, it was awesome. Everyone was really, really, it wasn't a mellow, it was just a constant, you know, energy. Everyone was just up. They were up. They were up,
yeah.
You know, both days and Friday. Perfect. Absolute perfect. So.
Okay. So just a couple of comments here, quick. Yeah. Because I know you get callers. So the video, or not the video, the snapshot that you've got on your, when you do the unlive feed,
yeah,
with the chick with the rifle, and he is saying, you say gravity one more time. I swear, well, Karen, that's you.
That's it? Karen.
Yes, that is me.
Yeah.
That is me.
Of course it is.
That's five years ago, I think.
Almost, yeah. It's a while ago now.
Yeah.
Well, there wasn't quite as much gray, but the gray is good, so don't worry about it.
No, yeah, Karen has come into her own now. I mean, I try to tell people, I go, when I was in Raleigh, Karen could have walked by you and you wouldn't have, you know, you wouldn't have picked up on that whole cool vibe rocker chick thing that she's got going on. But now, oh God, I totally.
Oh God, exactly.
There are bands that would pay good money to have her, you know, follow them on tour. not in that weird way.
Exactly.
You know, just when it's like, band, seriously, like lifelong.
No, not
band.
In a weird way, no.
The Deftones are, they don't know how fortunate they are to have a fan like Karen.
Exactly.
That's silly. Yeah. Oh, thank you.
So I'm not going to take up a whole lot of time.
Yeah.
Just wanted to throw that commentary out there and let you folks know that love everything that you're doing. And shout outs to Jan and Zulu and all the regulars. And you guys rock and roll, man. Just keep on going.
Thank you. We're going to certainly try.
Do my best.
Yeah. All right, man. Hey, you have a good one.
All right, guys. Have a great night.
We'll talk soon. All right.
Wearing my shirt.
I love, by the way, the black shirt this year. Very nice. Flattober 22.
Like that with Metatron's cube on there.
Yep. Manifest your
Manifest
reality.
Manifest your reality. And a lot of people, a lot of the speakers, you know, brought that kind of that hinted at that a little bit, that we do have the power to co-create our reality, and it really does have a lot to do with your state of mind and how you think about things and where you envision yourself and your attitude and the energy you put out. And so I love that, and I felt like everybody at the event was all about putting out that good energy, man.
Yeah,
it really was one of the best events. I mean, I everybody kept saying it. And I have to agree, you know, this was my fifth event, and I enjoyed myself probably the most at this event than any of the other ones that I've ever done.
Yeah.
And I have to say, you know, a lot of that, I think, is part of, like, a lot of the people that are negative, like a lot of the negative people who would come to the events and then leave and then talk crap. Yeah, they just weren't even there this time. They just weren't there, and they weren't missed.
Nope.
And it made it better. And so, you know.
Yeah. And again, when was it Rick or was it you? I think it was Rick. When, you know, asked, you know, how many new people? bunch of people, first timers.
Tons of new people, and I love it because all these new people get to come and they get to have this great experience, this really great high vibration, high energy, just completely positive experience.
Yep.
And that's what I want. That's what I want. And all the children running around and playing with other children, other, you know, knowing that, you know, getting to experience that, you know, that they're not the only family or their parents aren't the only ones, because it can be kind of awkward sometimes in your day-to-day life, you know, being the odd man out and having these different views on the world. And so it was just really great to see everybody get together and celebrate it and just be super happy. Yeah. It makes me happy to see other people happy, to see everyone happy. Truly does. Yeah. So it was great.
Yeah. You know, Jack's children, two of them bit me, but that, you know.
Only two of them?
I know, right? And we're not talking small. We're talking like goat. Like, you know, intensity, you know, I would, you know, if I hadn't pulled back, I would have lost a tip of a finger. Let's pick up one more before the break, which is going to be 716. We'll give you a few minutes. What's happening up there in New York?
Yeah, what's up, Mark? And Karen, it's Flat Earth Subgenius Dan.
Hey.
It's nice to finally get to talk and meet you guys in person.
Right on, man.
Yes.
Yeah. Did you have fun?
Hey, I'm still, oh my gosh, I'm so tired, but I'm still like in overload bliss mode and blissed out.
What time did you, or what, did you leave time. On Monday or did you leave today?
This is my full first day back. The Canadian boys drove me back. I stayed at an extra morning with, I just so happened to meet up with Shelly and Colleen and Wesley and Brian the next morning and ate some breakfast at some log cabin and went to see the river and walk through the woods and with a bunch of new people that I didn't really even connect with. So I was just meeting all types of people. It was so many people, so many, so much going on, the presentation, all the presentators, the speakers, performers. It's just like,
yeah,
makes a carnival look mild.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. There was a lot going on, but it was, yeah, it was all good, which is what I loved.
Yeah,
yeah. Well, cool.
Yeah, Karen, that was great. I can't wait to see this final performance with us all on stage dancing with Chief Crow.
Yeah, it's gonna be great.
That's so cool. So are you going to make any announcements about anything yet, or are you just going to keep down low?
I don't have any announcements to make yet, Dan. It's too soon.
Yeah, I was about to say, I only got back yesterday.
I was sleeping half the day, Dan. I had to recover still.
Yeah, she had a nap.
I'm going to sleep after this show.
Right?
Yeah, I know, right?
I got so many interviews coming up. Yo, do you know, Mark or Karen or anyone in the comment section, do you know Steve Hughes, the famous Australian comedian? He does a joke called I Was Offended. If you just type in I Was Offended, Steve Hughes.
I will look him up.
It'll be the health and safety. Or there's the quick one. It's just called I Was Offended. It's 2 or 3 minutes long.
Okay.
So you can bust it out real quick. But the point is very strong. It's just about words and how people get so offended and how it means nothing. So right. I'm going to interview this guy. And he's got like hundreds of thousands, perhaps even millions of followers. And it's all comedy and music. Actually, yeah, the music things too, because he was in two bands. Death metal bands in Australia. He's the second most famous comedian in Australia besides Jim Jefferies.
Cool.
He's anti-evolution, anti-Big Bang, anti-science, and anti-establishment. So I'm gonna start him off with that, and then the moon landing stuff, and then I'll flat smack him at the end for the finale.
Right on. Very, very cool. Well, we have to go to our final break. Do you have do you have any other shout outs? Do you have any last words?
The Flat Earthship crew, we're building our Earthships together and starting the Flat Earth economy. So keep that in mind. And it's going to be serious. But let's all get some sleep.
All right, man. You get some rest, okay?
All right. Later, man.
All right. See ya.
Later, Dan.
And with that, we are going to our final break. Hey, Karen. Kick in that smooth beat action.
Yeah, by the way, just so you guys know, I did not fix my commercial yet. It's still going to show you the Flattoberfest commercial, but...
What? There's a Flattoberfest coming? Is it next week?
It's the old Flattoberfest.
the old Flattoberfest from 2 days ago?
Yeah. A little bit. But, you know, it'll be fine.
She'll get it for next show. Promise. I can't promise.
I will get it for next show.
All right.
Where is the curvature?
Flattoberfest, it's back. Greenville, South Carolina, October 22nd and 23rd. With the grand return of Mark Sargent.
Yeah, I know that guy.
And live music from Chief Crow and the Flat Earth Worms. Austin Witsit of Witsit Gets It.
Gets It.
Benjamin Baldison of Holden's Alchemy. Jason Lindgren of Secrets of Saturn and Crow 777 Radio. Marty Leet of GnosticAcademy.org. One Big Love. How the World Works with Cammie and Zach. And new music by Austin and Kai Witsit. Sean Griffin of Kingdom in Context. Reserve your tickets at flatearthfestivals.com.
Oh, Rick.
I didn't hear Rick call again. Did he hang up? Why did he hang up?
Who?
Rick.
Rick was on the line?
Mm-hmm.
What did you know? You recognize the number?
Are you curious about crypto? Want to learn cryptocurrency before government digital currency is forced on you? You can go to cryptoclass101.com.au and sign up to learn crypto from this intelligent, flat earth friendly group of people. Jaren, Scott, Caprice, and Nathan are all very knowledgeable and can help you get started or expand your beginner knowledge. They have beginner and intermediate classes, one-on-one private coaching. They cover subjects such as buying, selling, swapping, decentralized finance, safety and security, asset recovery, and privacy coins. Use code KAREN10 to get 10% off of any service booked.
Welcome back to Strange World, part 4 of 4. To me and Karen B, and we better pick up this call because I don't know when he's going to disappear next. The one, the only, the MC since 2017, Rick Hummer. What's happening, Rick?
What's it mean when it's line unmuted?
Means you can talk, dork. Dude, why are you even playing this? You were in radio for years. I don't want to hear that.
I never use that button. Well, all I gotta say is, what a great time. What a great event. And like you were saying earlier, Karen, like just happy people everywhere.
Mm-hmm. It was great.
It was great.
You had fun more than most. Appreciate it.
I what?
You had more fun than most.
Oh, yeah. No, that was my mission. That was my mission. The agency said go there and have as much fun as you possibly can, even if you're just, you know, staying alone.
Yeah.
Pretend you're having fun. And I didn't have to pretend.
And you saved us because you were the one that got us in that first day when the doors were locked.
Listen, before I say anything, incriminate me. Are we live?
No, we're not.
I did get us in. And Trisha and that entire gang, that entire staff, they were great people, man.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
They work their butts off.
Yeah, they do. And they love us for some reason.
Yeah.
Don't know what it is, but they really enjoy us.
It, you know, it's funny. So when we were down below, one of the guys came in that was an active member of that place, right?
Yeah.
And he kind of said something funny. He's like, you guys sick of the crazies up there yet? And the one, I won't say any names, but the main guy says, let's just call him Craig. Craig says, what do you mean? He goes, you are one of them. And I really thought that he was joking with him. And then I realized, no, one of the guys, I think it was 2 years ago, came up there and ended up talking to some people. And it kind of struck a nerve with him. And he went home and started researching. And he's a flat earther.
And they remembered this two years later? And they remembered this two years later?
Remember. That's the whole thing. Those guys, they don't care. They're like, whatever, man. Those guys are hunting and fishing on the weekends. That's what they normally do.
Right.
And, you know, it's you know, they don't have a lot of members. It's a dying, you know, thing down there.
Sure. Yeah.
I don't think it's the same organization today as it was in 1973.
No. It's tough. You know, the membership for...
A little bit more laid back.
For people who are listening to this for the first time, the event was held at the Shriners Event Center, which is basically a Masonic event center. And you know what? They helped us out when the pandemic was crushing everybody. And they're like, no, you guys come in. You don't have to wear a mask or any requirements. Come on in.
Yep.
Have some beers.
Yeah, exactly.
Sorry.
They're on the same exact page as all of us on almost everything but Flat Earth.
Yeah.
Crazy. And that's just some of them. Who knows how many other ones are already there? Like, I can only imagine what that guy's like going around during the meetings or whatever they do, probably on Sunday, beer drinking, watching the race. You know, it's like he's winning debates.
Right.
I mean, if he's been for a couple of years, they probably don't want to talk about it.
Yeah. It was so much fun hanging out with you, because every time I ran into you, it was like you had a new story that wasn't even 10 minutes old. You know, it's like, oh yeah, I was down in the basement of the Maces, you know, drinking at their bar, you know, watching the last 30 laps of NASCAR. That's like, what? Why? And
the chocolates, the little British lady that brought us chocolates. John and I were sitting in there, and this little lady, came up, and at first I thought she was messing with us, and I realized, no, she's really got an accent. And she gave us, like, chocolates that she brought in that she made. And I was just like, and we just got treated like we were family there. It was just great. I felt like I was at the American Legion back in North Liberty, Indiana.
Very similar. It's kind of funny. Very similar vibe to the American Legion groups.
Yeah. It's like I ran into somebody's mom, and she's like, what have you two been up to? Like, checking Flat Earth. She didn't want any part of that. No. On the English Channel when she was younger. That's how she met her husband. I thought that was a great story. She met her husband while she was swimming in the English Channel. He was in the U.S. military and saw her from the ship.
Wow. That makes sense.
And wait until she came in.
See a hot chick in the water. You're in a boat full of guys. Seems pretty natural.
So. Yeah. It's crazy. But yeah.
Well, cool, man.
Pick me. But what I was going to say is, Karen, you know, I had a lot of people asking me if you were going to do it again there. And I said, I don't know. And the beans, or maybe you guys told them, but the hall found out that you guys may not be having it there. And I honestly thought they were going to cry. I'm not kidding. Wow. I'm not kidding you. Like, he was like, man, I heard you. I'll be here next year. I said, I don't know. I have nothing to do with that. And he's like, man, I really hope they come back. I really love you guys, man. I look forward to this. He said, I actually cleared my schedule for this event. So I didn't know that the president actually ran the karaoke until about an hour of being down there. And I realized this guy's the president of the lodge or whatever this is.
Yeah.
And he's running the beat. And it was like being at the VF or a Legion here back home.
Wow.
Or a place called the Wabash back in the day.
Very, very cool. Very, very cool. Yeah, but I got a funny feeling Flattoberfest isn't going to die so easily.
Probably
hey,
not.
Hey, man, hate to do this to you, but unfortunately we got to take some other callers. I got your thing, by the way. And I'm going to read your... Say it again, Rick.
I'm cutting you off. Go ahead, Mark.
Oh no! I was just saying, I got your thing, and I'm going to be reading through part of that tomorrow when I get a chance. My vision is blurry still right now.
My thing.
The
script.
Yes. Not the one you sent, but the one that he sent to me.
Yeah. Right. Okay.
Yeah. That one.
Yeah. Good. I'm glad it came through. Karen, I just want to tell you, I love you. I can't thank you enough for such a great weekend. And Ted, too. I mean, you guys, every time I turn on, you guys are running around. And don't forget what happened in the hallway with the three of us and the
conspiratorial. I have the photographic evidence.
Yeah. Okay. Don't lose that.
I got it.
Don't lose that.
All right.
And if anything ever happens, if anything ever happens to me, it was Karen and Ted.
and when, by the way, just parting shot before you go, when the commercial is done for Bolton's, I think I can talk Karen into airing it a couple times on this show.
Got to.
Oh yeah, that can replace my Flattoberfest commercial for a while.
Yeah, it's about nine, I think. Wow.
Oh, by the way, I just got a message from Stefan just now, and I have to repeat it.
What is it?
Because we were talking about how we got the tumblers that he sent as gifts.
Oh,
he doesn't sell those. Oh. Those are not on the website. Those are custom tumblers. Like,
oh my God.
You got one of those tumblers, y'all. That's a custom special gift.
Oh, from Stefan. I didn't realize
either. I thought, because he had them, I thought he was selling them too. They were part of his website, or like it was like a thing, but it's not. I guess he's saying anybody can order custom Yetis, and he got those. That was his gift to us. So,
wow.
Thank you, Stefan.
Yeah, no, thank you.
That was nice.
But he does have cool stuff on his website. He's got socks and fanny packs and shirts and phone cases and on all. He does have a lot of cool stuff.
If you're one of the people that got the Yeti tumbler, put it on eBay right now, and we will vouch for it. Oh, that's awesome. That's really, really great.
Wait a second. Karen, do you remember? Look at your phone. Look at the picture. Do you remember this? Did it come true?
Yeah. Yes.
I'm guessing I wasn't in that picture.
No, you are in it.
I am.
Yes,
actually, you are.
You are. Oh, the camera! You got to show it. No, don't.
No,
it was just the way that it happened. All the tumblers got lined up, and Mark stood behind it.
I lined those up.
It was.
Yeah, no, that was it. Yeah, that was it. That was at Karen's house.
Yeah.
The strong flat earthers are retarded.
Yeah.
All right, man.
Anyway, I love you guys. Thank you so much. And Ted, man, this is how my day ended when we left yesterday. So I'm sitting next to Ted. We're talking like literally 20 seconds. And he shoots up. Oh, there it is. Yeah. He shoots up. And I'm thinking he's just going to get up and come right back. And I didn't realize that you guys were like leaving. So I didn't even say bye to Ted. So tell Ted I'll see him later.
All right.
I don't know what that means. That's right. RK Rick, I'm cutting you off. We got to go.
Bye.
See you, Ben.
Bye.
Rick Hummer, ladies and gentlemen. All right, we can pick up a couple more, I think. You know what? I'm gonna pick up Alex just to see if he's next to his, if it's working or not. New York, Alex, are you there this time?
Can you hear me now? Can you hear me?
Alex, are you there?
Yes.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, I'm dicking with you.
Can you hear me?
Go ahead. Yes, shut up. What is it? Yeah, you're here.
Oh, okay. Just because I did this the last time I called in, and you guys were like,
"Oh no, we absolutely couldn't hear you last time. We heard nothing.
I can't hear you.
We didn't even hear clicking."
What? You didn't hear what?
Clicking. Any, like even static, like bars reception.
Oh, it's probably just because I don't know. I don't have any answer for that. How are you guys doing? You guys good?
Yeah, man. Did you get some sleep?
No, not really. I had an amazing trip back, chatted with a bunch of people, that I met, and it was super fun, and you never get enough time with everybody on this whole thing, but like generally, the big question I want to ask is, do you live on the first floor, the second floor, or the third floor of your house?
We're not doing the David Weiss skit. We're not doing that one. I know this one. I don't. How does he find all of you people? My God. How does he do it?
I don't care what.
Oh my God. I'm really hoping the whole bio, that Mark is, or is it? I'm David's father thing isn't going to stick either. Working that one pretty hard.
Just having fun.
I know.
Just having fun, dude. I'm like, what else do we have? What else do we have?
Besides picking on Mark, there's lots of things.
We've got nothing. This is all we can do is make fun of it and have a good time, right?
Thanks. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Thanks. No, it was great. That was awesome. And I got to hear your song, which we play at the end of this show live, which was great.
I thought it was pretty good. I don't know. That's just me.
did you have it?
It sounds a lot better with a band, but
yeah, I know. Just a couple guys up there. Hey, no, the song I play at the end of the show. I love that song. I think it's great. Myres.
I think Crumb is still in. He's still down there. Crumb is still there. He hasn't figured out how to get home yet.
Are you serious?
He's still in. He's still down there. But this is how Crumb works. He just sort of decides how he's going to get back home. Basically within like 5 hours, but he's still there. I think he's still at the Airbnb that we had. I don't know.
Did you reserve it for that long? Crumb,
please.
Is Crumb okay?
I don't know what he's doing. He didn't have a ticket back. He might just live there now. He just lives in Greenville now. He just lives there.
Oh.
Okay. I love you guys. And it was really great to see everybody. I love all you fuckers. You're the best in the world, and we are winning. Okay, bye.
All right. See you, man. Alex Lowry, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah. He got to play on stage, which was great, and got to hang out with him, which I hadn't really done in person. And it was fun. Mm-hmm. And he made fun of me. I will say the I have not laughed that hard in a while when we went up to Rose's room with David and Paige and Rick and I and a couple other people. And and when he was making fun of me, again, where he stops, he goes, because you got to remember that Alex can be the quiet type sometimes. So he would hang in the background. He was watching me talk to people, and then other people would shuffle through, and I'd be talking to them. It was this rotating thing. And so he goes, he just out of the blue, he goes, so how many words do you think you've said today? I'm guessing 4,000. And he wasn't, he was basically saying that I talk too much. So thank you, Alex, for that.
Yeah, but 4,000 is not a lot of words.
No, it's not a lot of words. And I think it was low. I think that was
very low.
It was a low number. But what he was saying was that he just kept going on. It's like every time I see you, or with a different person going rah, 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 rah. You know, yippity, bibbity, yeah. Bibbity. It's like, and he just, the way his delivery was so perfect. And we just were just howling. David's got a clip of the back end of it. It was awesome. Anyway, do we have
time? Did you see me in chat? You see the message I sent you in chat?
Oh, wait. Oh, okay. I'll pick up him, and then we'll close with Oh, you can edit. Anyone can edit that section in the middle, the caller name.
I can. I did. Oh. Yeah, I edited it too. Yes.
Oh, I'd never clicked in there. Go figure. You know what? We're gonna pick him up. 530. It's you, me, and Karen B.
Hail, Karen. Hail, Mark.
Hey.
I wanted to say that Christy and I, we don't come down off the mountain very often, and we've been wanting to do this for a couple of years now, and it was so much more than we ever expected. It was, the people were absolutely beautiful all around. There was such a just amazing, uplifting, happy feeling everywhere. The most smiling faces I've ever seen. The speakers were all awesome. It couldn't have been better.
I agree. Awesome. Thank you for coming and being a part of it. It was so great to meet you and Christy in real life too. That was awesome.
It was great meeting you guys all too. We're still at it. We were out with Brian Stavely and his crew last night and hanging out with a bunch of the guys and some of the people that are also hanging behind, and we're still just enjoying it, trying to make the most of it while we're off the mountain. And actually on Saturday I had supper with a 32nd degree Mason. That was pretty funny, and he was actually very nervous because he was having supper with Freeman and I, and you could see he was just visibly nervous. And he'd said that he would like to talk to go on a show and talk to some people and face some of the things that they say about the Freemasons and clear that up. And then to that I said, so how many hand jobs have you given George Bush in a closet? And he looked at me and said, what? And I said, and that's why you're not a 33rd degree Mason.
Wow. Nice. Well done.
That's hilarious.
Thank you guys. It was an absolute pleasure meeting you, and thank you everybody else that came. You guys are all just absolutely beautiful. We love you all.
We Very love cool. you too. It was. How long are you in town for? When are you guys leaving?
We're gonna go see James and Najla from Grounded tomorrow, and hopefully Cammy, and maybe you again. And so yeah, we're not leaving until like tomorrow night or maybe Thursday morning, one or the other.
Okay, good. I want to see you guys again before you go, for sure.
Yeah, definitely. But we'll make that happen tomorrow.
Okay, sweet.
We love you guys, and it was a pleasure meeting you.
All right, yeah, you too.
All right. See you, man.
Bye. So great.
Yeah, have a good one.
That's another thing I really love about these events. You get to meet all the people that you get to know throughout you know, over the years, and you get to meet them in real life and shake their hand and give them a hug and look them in the eye. And it just really brings your friendship to another level. Like, you can get to know people pretty well over line now with like video conferencing and talking and stuff, right? But when you meet someone in real life, that's it. Now you've shaken their hand, you can break bread, you know, you can hug. I mean, there's nothing like it.
Yeah. I lost count of the amount of people that introduced themselves as their chat room name, for example.
Yeah.
You know, it's like, I look at their tag. It's like, no, they would say, no, I'm such and such in chat. It's like, really? Unfortunately for me, you know, I don't look at, you know, cause I don't want to be distracted. I don't look at the chat room that much, but you've mentioned them enough in passing. Like, oh, okay, it's that person. It's that person. So,
yeah.
Well, it's time to pick up one call, and I won't rub it in too much. It was a man that we missed sorely at this event, and I know it wasn't his fault, but so I'll bring him in gently. You ready? Start spreading the news. I'm leaving today. I haven't forgotten Truesmacks. I want to be a part of it. Truesmacks.
New York, New York.
There you go.
My vagabond shoes.
They're longing to stray right through the very heart of it.
Oh, my goodness.
You're supposed to say New York, New York. There you go. That's fine.
And, you know, just so you know, you probably use 40,000 words a day. They say men use 20,000 and men use 500. So there's that.
There is that.
I can't believe you could even talk. Jesus.
Do you know what saved me was Karen's middle room. That's what it was. Because once the music fired up, I told people, I go, the problem is when the music fires up, you have to yell to answer questions. You know, they'd be like, so tell me about solar eclipses. And I go, well, first of all, you can only do that for a couple hours.
Right. So,
the middle room was very quiet. You could go into a corner and it was awesome. So yeah, but after a week, I'm still a little frazzled, but thank you. I mean, I'm recovering quickly. So there you go. Got a couple interviews tomorrow. See how those go.
Cool. Yeah, good turnout. I have a quote.
Yeah.
All right. I don't know who actually said this. I don't know. I don't know. You must always be willing to truly consider evidence that contradicts your beliefs and admit the possibility that you may be wrong. Intelligence isn't knowing everything. It's the ability to challenge everything you know. And I think it's great because, like you said, you had so many new people. And, I mean, the people there, to go from these people are nuts, flat earthers, to now they're believe it. You know, I mean, it's just. That's incredible stuff, I think.
Yeah. No, I mean, as I mentioned during the thing, we've had so many more new people because of the pandemic, because they were forced to stay at home and watch media that they normally wouldn't watch. And then now that everything's rolled back, now they're going outside going, you're never going to guess what I watched over the last year. And it's like, yeah, I can believe it. So
and
of course, the kids with the TikToks.
Well, yes, of course. There's that. So the Mason hat wasn't rigged, huh? For a Mason to win.
No, that was just weird. But everybody I told the story to, they all said the same thing. It's like they use some sort of Mason magic.
Oh my goodness!
That is so weird.
It is so weird. Is it?
But that's like totally. so typical of the universe, though.
Yeah. Yeah, and
right.
Because we had two guys at the conference that were flat earthers. They were both Masons. One was a Templar, one was Scottish Rite, and they knew each other. but neither of them were part of that lodge. Completely different lodges. And it just seemed like routine. That's, you know, the guy's like, oh yeah, I want it. I was like it didn't seem like it was a really original, you know, a rare occurrence. Whatever. Some magic happening.
Right. It's like, yeah, whatever.
Whatever.
Maybe now that he has the hat, he'll try to research it and he'll realize what he's got.
Yeah, maybe.
Oh, wake up to it, right? Open his eyes.
Mm-hmm.
There you go. Challenge what he knows.
Yeah.
Or what he thinks he knows.
It's Exactly.
Right, right, right.
Yeah.
Crazy.
Well, any shout outs? Because we're getting close to the end. I know Karen wants to run.
Shout out to you guys.
Because we're
and you said Peanut's MIA. Yeah.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Let's mention that real quick. Do you know where he is? Peanut Gallery is
yeah, whatever happened to Peanut?
Negative. I have not had any responses from him either.
It's probably an internet issue.
Is his internet down? I mean,
it's gotta be internet.
It could be as simple as a fucking weather thing with him where he's at.
Oh yeah, I didn't look that up. I should probably look that up. It's like, you know, his part of the state has been leveled. Hard to say.
Yeah. There's that.
All right. Well, I'm not gonna think the worst. But again, you know, Zula was there last year. And he knows, you know, I had regret for not going last year, but this year I was so glad that I went. And again, we'll have to see what happens in the future. Because from what I can tell, you know, go ahead.
Oh, I was curious. I wanted to ask, how was your flight? Any incidents?
No. It's, you know, 10 to 20% of the people are wearing masks, and all they do different is the plane before you take off, they announce that masks are optional, so everyone should just get along. You know, no fighting. And they do.
Fight over if the guy next to you doesn't have one on.
Yeah, exactly. You know, so people sit with their mask and you can tell that's what they're going to do. And neither side's going to give each other crap. So, okay, cool. Fine by me. So,
crazy.
No problem.
Crazy. Yep. I pick up my boy from school and there's still kids that come out because this year he went back and there's still kids that have masks on. I'm like, what are they doing?
Mm.
What the fuck?
Mm. I'm hoping that the kids, you know, if their parents make them wear them, the kids will figure out, you know, they'll dig into it and figure out their own options later. So we'll see.
I don't think they're making them wear them. I think at this point, these children are programmed because there's no parent there to watch over them. And did you ever do what your parents told you when you were in school? No, of course not. So I think they're fully programmed. It's disgusting.
I wasn't much of a rebel in high school.
Well, I know you, but you had street cred though, right?
Well, yeah, later. Really. Later when, you know, I tried to blow up a university and that whole thing. So,
well, that's a whole different thing.
Yeah, it's a whole different thing. I graduated young. So by the time I turned 18, yeah, that's when all hell broke loose. And I was like, laws? More like guidelines.
Absolutely. Speed limits are just, those speed signs are just guidelines. Recommended in case.
Speed limits.
That's all.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah.
Red and blue just means drive faster. Anyway, we gotta go.
Absolutely.
So, we'll be here. We're doing this without a producer. So, we'll be here next week. Same flat time, same flat channel.
Absolutely.
Say goodnight, Karen, queen of conventions.
Good night.
Say good night, Zulu.
Good night, Zulu.
And when Peanut finally comes out of the bunker, hopefully he'll just light up a cigarette at the end of this episode. And it's like, well done.
Yes.
Karen.
Yeah.
take us to the final music track.
All right.
By Alex Lowry.
Yes, by Lowry. And thank you for joining Mark and I for another episode of Strange World.
All right. Hot sex.
Hot sex.
Hot sex.
Good night, everybody.
All right. Thanks for being here. Thanks for joining Mark and I. Thank you to... Who is it? Water. Let me say the name again. Water Star. Thank you for the tip on Rockfin. Appreciate it.
as it's ever been. Wound up chasing stars all over again. There's words for what you got, what you have, and what you'll ever need.